Hello and welcome to Kymi Sinfonietta's Baroque concert this January. We're very happy that you were able to make it. We have a wonderful program prepared for you and we hope you enjoy it very much. My name is Raymond. I am the concertmaster of the orchestra and we've been working all week on this program, so enjoy. Bieber was an excellent writer for violin, and while it does show itself in this sonata, this is slightly different character than what he would normally write for one or two or three violins, because he was quite virtuosic in his writing. But his decision to include trumpets and write in a much more serious sonata form, he changed very much how he was writing for the strings, and he gave a very important role for our trumpets. The normal character of his music can be quite wild, extremely rich, thick harmonies, and while he does maintain the same harmonic language, the trumpets add a certain seriousness, a very, very pompous, in a positive way, a pompousness to the music that sort of commands a little more seriousness to it. So this was a nice change from Bieber that we've been playing previously, which is far more virtuosic in character. the Graupner that we're playing in this concert is actually originally written for three Baroque clarinets or Chalumeau. And it, there aren't very many like it. And the instrument was still very young at the time when it was written. And so it's very clear that the composer is having a lot of fun trying out new things for the instrument, trying to bring out new qualities and new colors, things that weren't very common for the time. And so the piece is quite large, and it has a lot of different variety in textures, in tones, in melodies, and it's quite nicely suited for the instrument. In our case, we used one bassoon instead of a third clarinet because the register was quite perfect, actually, for a bassoon. It sounded quite nice, and we have excellent players that can sort of make the adjustments. So we're using a slightly different instrumentation, but the results were quite nice. I was very happy with it.
Thank you. Thank you.
As for the Lully, some of our listeners will probably recognize that these four different movements don't belong to the same piece. There's a couple of reasons for that. One, because this is a concert setting and not a ballet or an opera, we don't have a story to tell through that music. All the pieces are in a way very removed from each other. And that gives us the freedom to sort of pick and choose what we want to. And wanted to sort of include as much very festive, extremely happy, light and warm music that can be found in French Baroque in amazingly, staggeringly huge amounts. There's this music for this time period is extremely colorful, and when it's given the right treatment, it's very hard to sit still and listen to it because it's a little too joyful to simply sit and listen passively. So even for the musicians, it's a rewarding experience, and really I can't say enough good things about the French Baroque. Another lesser known composer that we were able to use in this program was Heinichen, the concerto for horns and orchestra. This was also fun because it requires a different instrument for our horn players than what they would usually normally use. Of course, they have their modern instruments and natural horns, but this is a specific type of Baroque horn written for this type of music, and it wouldn't have been possible without these instruments. So it was a great experience for the players to try out something new, and you can hear it's quite virtuosic. He's asking quite a lot from the horn players. But even though the piece itself is quite compact, it doesn't take very long, not very many minutes at least, but there's quite a lot of interesting material written in. It's also kind of interesting also how he used the different instruments in this piece, because while the strings and the continuo make up the bulk of the orchestration, he decides to include two flutes in the second movement. And this is not unheard of, but it's kind of unusual to reserve an instrument for only a small piece of a larger work. Usually, when a composer has access to an instrument, especially one that's versatile as a flute, it would be logical for them to use it as much as possible throughout the work. But he specifically reserved it for a very slow and sensitive second movement with the strings, and this was maybe a unique choice on his part, but it had some very nice results, so we were happy with how it came out in the end.